Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Trombley and I'm with the Windows Servicing and Delivery team here at Microsoft. I frequently work with commercial customers, and when it comes to upgrading from Windows 10 to 11, some fear the transition has the potential to create anxiety and frustration, and slow down productivity for that matter. With Windows 11, we have prioritized security and a modern design with more freedom to customize your device to work for your specific needs. Working in a fast-paced environment, you may not have the time to search for tips and how-tos. You just want it to work. Well, I'd like to help. Has your cheese moved, been enhanced, or in some cases been removed? Well, in this short video, I'll walk through the essentials in Windows 11 and talk about how things have changed since Windows 10. The goal is to help you get the most out of intuitive navigation and multitasking capabilities in Windows 11, so you can work productively from anywhere, anytime. So without further ado, let's get rolling. Let's talk about what's changed in Windows 11. Starting with the taskbar. One of the first things you'll notice is that the taskbar has shifted to the center of your screen and features application icons without labels. I don't know about you, but I often use a large monitor or multi-monitor situation at work or at home, and this feature scales nicely as I open more applications. If you love the way it was in Windows 10 though, guess what? Simply right-click in the taskbar and select Taskbar Settings to position it to the left. Now let's talk about the Start menu. Once you've aligned the taskbar to your liking, you'll quickly notice changes to the Start menu, which now reflects a cleaner, more streamlined, and organized look. App tiles have been eliminated, and power settings have shifted down there to the right. In addition, we've dropped some intelligence in there aligned with your calendar and workday. Need a file for that upcoming meeting? Chances are associated files will pop up aligned to the specific upcoming topic. On the right of the taskbar, we took away the cluttered Windows 10 visuals and updated or streamlined the Action Center, which includes the quick settings, notifications, and a new Focus Assist feature. At the very bottom right, you'll notice the notification icon, which behaves in similar fashion to Windows 10. You'll occasionally see a circle notification to get your attention concerning system performance or reminders. It's meant to be discreet and in just the right place. Within the notifications icon, you'll see at the bottom that Focus Assist is shortened to Focus. This new button provides more options than the off, priority only, and alarms only that were featured before. Here, once you adjust the time and hit play on Focus, it'll take you to the clock app, where you can expand the window to full view. You can then customize the goals and tasks that you want to accomplish in a Focus session. Heading back to the taskbar and slightly to the left of the notifications, there's the Quick Settings menu, which is accessed by clicking on the connectivity, volume, or battery icon. If you have touchscreen, you can simply swipe up on the system tray. Here, you'll still have access to similar Windows 10 settings, except that now you can customize them by pinning your favorite ones to this menu. Skipping over to the File Explorer, moving files is made easier by using the new Tab feature. Just press the plus sign at the top, pick a folder, then drag and drop between tabs. Another thing you'll notice are the new icons when you right-click a document. We've organized the old menu so that commonly used actions are at the very top. But if you miss the older look, you can click Show More Options on the same menu. The task view changes are short and sweet, with a simplified redesign of the icon and the view of multiple desktops located at the bottom rather than at the top when managing views. A bonus feature within the virtual desktops is the ability to customize wallpapers and personalize each virtual desktop. For easier Windows management and organization, we offer you the Snap Layouts and Snap Groups. You don't have to manually snap windows again unless you want to. Simply hover over the Minimize, Maximize icon or press Windows logo key plus Z to open Snap Layout templates. To see more Snap layout templates, drag the minimized window to the top of the screen. Another neat trick when working on a specific task, snap two or more open apps or windows to create a Snap group. When you want to get back to the Snap group later, hover over one of your open apps in the taskbar to find it. Ease of access was discreetly hidden in the bottom of settings, so we wanted to make it more convenient to find by moving it to the quick settings menu, where you'll see its new name, accessibility. Here, you can turn on narrator, live captions, sticky keys, and more. This is one of my favorites, Snipping Tool. Moving on to the Snipping Tool, you can do more than just screenshot, introducing the new record option. Simply select an area and hit the video cam icon. You'll also find that the Snipping Tool automatically saves your screenshots. To access them, you can select See More, Open Screenshots Folder. Glorious. Lastly, going into the Start menu, Windows 10 would just add widgets from the app list. Now you can gain control of what widgets you'd like to be shown or hidden from. You could personalize the news, weather, calendar, and other information at a glance just through the taskbar settings. We hope this gets you well on your way and acquainted with Windows 11. Look for future updates and enhancements as part of Microsoft's regular updates throughout the product lifecycle. As always, we encourage you to ask questions, post below, or to subscribe to our channel. If there are additional user interface topics you'd like to learn more about in the future, please let us know in the comments section below. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.